Shame.
You know, there's a history that, you know why the church is built this way?
The ark of the.
Yeah, it's like a boat. And then the sanctuary, the ark was a sanctuary. Just a little history, so we're sinking from one side. All right, does anybody have any announcements for the fellowship?
I do. We had our cookie walk yesterday, and we did okay. We didn't do as well as we did last year, but we will be selling cookies after church for those of you who missed it, so.
All right.
Thank you for your time and your.
Get your cookies. If not, Mark's going to have to go out and set up the little stand on aisle for the church. It's a little cold. He's got a cold, and it's a little cold out there today, so. All right, anybody else? Any other announcements? Well, do you realize that Christmas Eve is on Tuesday?
Yeah.
Do you know that?
Yeah.
Okay, so here is the quiz. What time does church start on Christmas Eve?
8:00.
Okay, good. All right, just check. Just check. All right. Huh?
Evening.
Candlelight service here in the sanctuary where we worship and welcome the Lord. Any other announcements for the good of the fellowship? Bible study, there's no Bible study on Monday. The next couple Mondays till after the holidays over. If there's nothing else, let's stand and sing.
Okay. The first Noel, the angel did say, was a certain poor shepherd in fields where they lay. Did he appear there, bringing in their sheep, on a cold winter's night that was so deep? Noel, born in such heat, Noel, born is our King.
God's messenger said to Joseph in a dream, do not hesitate to marry Mary, for that which is conceived in her is the gift of the Holy Spirit.
His name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us.
Humanly speaking, Jesus Christ is descended from King David, but by the work of the Holy Spirit, he is designated child of God.
His name shall be called Emmanuel, which means God with us.
And let us pray together.
God of Mary and Joseph,
and of all who look for the glory of God on earth, give us eyes to discern the work of your hands among us. Do not allow us to approach Christmas with our eyes closed to the remarkable things you do in complete simplicity. Fill us again with that humility until we awe and gratitude. May we see glimpses of your presence in many people and get ready to worship you in that outpouring of glory which began when a young woman carried Jesus Emmanuel in her body.
For your name's sake, amen.
May be seated. There's been three candles for hope, for peace, and for joy. And today we light the third candle of love. With this flame, we signify the love of God that surrounds and always fills us. But we recognize in a special way as we contemplate the Christmas story. There's no greater power than love. It is stronger than rulers and empires, stronger than grief or despair, stronger even than death. We love because God loves us. Let us say together, loving God, we open ourselves to you this Christmas season. As these candles are lit, light our lives in your imagination. Show us the creative power of hope. Teach us the peace that comes from justice. Fill us with the kind of joy that cannot be contained, but must be shared. Magnify your love within us. Prepare our hearts to be transformed by you, that we may walk in the light of Christ. Amen. As we continue to worship this morning, let us present God's power and our Lord God.
Father God, we thank you for your Son, Jesus. We thank you
want to know and experience the gift that we found in your Son Jesus. For it's in his name we pray. Amen. Until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. Thus ends the reading of the Lord.